Hello everyone, welcome to JKC Tutorials. In today's video, we'll understand what is Google Bard with some demo examples. Bard is a conversational generative AI chatbot developed by Google. To use Bard, go to bard.google.com and sign in using your Google account. When you log in, you see such a screen. You may change the chat theme from the settings icon. Let's learn what is Bard straight from the horse's mouth. Oh, already an error. I'm just a language model. You also have an option to regenerate the draft. Let's see. Same answer. We have already some feedback to give to Google. Let's click again. We'll try and edit our question. Okay, now it's given some answer to us. So it is a large language model or LLM by Google, trained on large data set to have a human-like conversation. It has given some examples also that if you want information on a topic, what is the meaning of life, translate languages, write a code, example, write a program in Python. But there are some disclaimers to note here. Bard is still under development and is not perfect, may give inaccurate or inappropriate responses. We just saw an example of an inaccurate response. We'll see more such examples at the end of the video, but let's first see how it can be useful in our day-to-day mundane tasks. Write a speech for me on India's Independence Day in 100 words. Yes, so it has given us a response here, my fellow Indians, all of this, Jai Hind. And you can also view the other draft responses which it generates. Like you can see, the start of it has changed today on our 76th Independence Day. Another good feature of it is, by default, it will give you a shorter version. But if you need something which is more professional, maybe for a school level, or if you want to send an email, it will reconstruct the context for you on that basis. Yes, so the more professional speech here. We'll see its casual version as well. As we can see, this is more of a casual response here. We'll confirm that these are actually within 100 words. You can copy the response from here. 132. So the problem is when you copy paste, this part of the response also gets copied. Here is the more casual speech. We'll just remove this and confirm. This ignores all the white spaces. So there are 116 words. Not bad, we'd asked for 100 and 116 is not that bad. Not highly accurate, but not that bad either. You can also listen to the response.
Sure. Here is a more casual speech for you on India's Independence Day in 100 words. Happy Independence Day, everyone. Today, we celebrate 76 years of freedom from Britain.
Write an emotional farewell email to a friend. We'll just keep it to default here. The good thing about this is that you can export your response to Gmail and a draft will be created in your Gmail. Create a PPT on ChatGPT. The response you can see is quite quicker and it will give you on each slide what content you can put in. You can always edit as per your choice, more professional you want it in more words. This is a longer output, as you can see. Downside of this is that you cannot export it to Google Slides like you would do for text in for Google Docs and Gmail. So maybe that feature will be added by the end of the year. The USP of Bard is that it works on real-time content as well. ChatGPT, which we use normally, is trained on 2021 data. And the recent GPT versions do support responses on real-time data, but are paid subscriptions. So let's try some real-time response here. Stock price of Google by R. So it has given the stock price of Google as of August 14, 9:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. And you can also explore this to Google Sheets. Also, there is a summary on what could affect the stock price of Google in future, earnings report, etc. You can also provide feedback to responses. You can like it if it's a good response. Also, for bad responses, you can hit the dislike button. There are times when we read some interesting article and we want to share it with our friends, and they may not have the time to go through all the text within a link. So you can summarize and you can just give the link of the article, and it will give you a summary of the article published by Harvard Business Review, which you can either copy paste and send it via IM, or you can share it with your Gmail. You can also send your responses as link. Suppose you and your team are working on some song lyrics. Generate song lyrics on singlehood. You can send this draft as a link. Share, create public link. And you may share this link with them and they can view this without having to logging into Bard. You can also send multiple links here if you want more drafts to be generated. This will be a separate link which you can share. So all your drafts can be shared via public links. And you can access all your public links from settings. You can delete all of them. It also helps you with code. Python program to loop array and print max value. You can see the response here, and there's an explanation of the function as well. Now, the best part about coding is when we click on more professional, you can see the docs are also printed and all the function names or the variables used are meaningful variables. So they do make use of the coding best practices when you click on professional. And also they've given you a reason on why it's professional. It has descriptive variable names, comments, uses functions to code, uses a main function. So this you can either copy paste it in your IDE, or you can also export it via Colab and Replit. All this while for the demo, I was using Firefox browser. We did not have a microphone icon here next to the prompt. It is only available for Chrome browser as of now. Let's try something with voice input. Is rebel the correct pronunciation?
The correct pronunciation of the word rebel depends on whether it is used as a verb or a noun.
So from here we can understand that if we are using it as a noun, the correct pronunciation is rebel. This feature is most useful when you're learning a new language. If you're not getting a good Instagram caption, Bard can help you with that as well. Click on the upload icon. Give me Instagram caption. Yes. So it gives you a list of all the captions that you can put in, short captions, cute captions, different types, funny, inspiration, etc. And also gives you sources from where it has taken. We saw some incorrect or no responses during our demo. Here are some more examples. I asked Bart to write a song for me in Sindhi. It gave me a totally out of context response. The title is Singlehood and all the lyrics are in Marathi. I asked Bard, how old are you? The response was not only vague but also contradictory. It says first activated in March 2023 and we are in August 2023. It's hardly some months, but it says that I have been around for a few years and there is no numerical figure at all in the response. One striking feature of Bing which Bard misses is image generation. We expected at least the Google Images links will be shared. Overall, it's a great tool for your day-to-day activities, very helpful and informative, customizable, and it integrates with our Google Apps, Gmail, Sheets, Collab Docs. Plus, it's free. My recommendation is use it, provide genuine feedback, and make it better. That's all from today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Please do share some use cases in comments as well for me also to look at. Happy learning.